mystery of stuff.
Waited Angel moments after having welcomed it into its life is definitely the most devastating experience. In such an ordeal, the parents usually face a hard time trying to cope with the loss, and the healing process is a very long one that starts with profound grief. Yet, when other people disrespect the memory of the loved ones that we lost and disparage the way we grieve, one can't help but feel enraged. Arizona couple Jacob and Tashonda Armstrong experienced that firsthand after they lost little McCade. Jacob and Tashonda lost their little boy, whom they named McCade, just a few minutes after his birth. And instead of watching him grow up, playing with his siblings and adding more joy to his family's life, the devastated couple had to bury their newborn kid. April 14, 2017 was a tragic day for the Armstrongs as complications during the delivery cost the couple their little baby. Yet it wasn't the only ordeal the family has to deal with, as other people found a way to make the mourning couple's sorrow even deeper. Little McCade lived for a few minutes only, but he was an Armstrong, a beautiful baby that Jacob and Tashonda witnessed his arrival to this world, a son who would always have a place in their hearts, even if they didn't get the chance to hold him and play with him. People honor the memory of their loved ones by grieving them, and everyone has his own way to do so. Jacob and Tashonda grieve their son by making sure he's never forgotten, and in one way or another, little McCade was always part of the family. The couple regularly visited the grave of their son at the Memorial Park Cemetery, and whenever they paid him a visit, they left flowers, letters, flags, toys, and pinwheels at his grave, hoping little McCade's spirit wouldn't feel lonely. Yet the baby's spirit would never get the chance to enjoy his parents' tokens. Not because he was dead, but because someone regularly came to take whatever the grief-stricken parents left for him. When the Armstrongs asked other people, it turned out that not only their son's tokens were going missing, but also those left on other graves at the cemetery. A pinwheel might have no value at all to whoever took it, but it's a symbol of love and affection of the couple who chose to leave such a little gift to their lost little one as a mechanism to cope with their sorrow. Grave robbing is not a new phenomenon, as graveyards witness the robbery of all sorts of stuff, including the theft of corpses in some extreme cases. Yet stealing the toys from the grave of a child can only be described as despicable, and can only devastate the grieving parents who are already anguished by their great loss. The Armstrongs thought about who or what could be behind the disappearance of little McCade's toys, and they couldn't determine whether the culprit was a human, an animal, or some supernatural phenomenon. Jacob was saddened by what was happening and decided to get to the bottom of it. He asked around and tried to see if anyone had an idea. Yet, sadly, no one tried to discover the reason behind the missing tokens before. Jacob finally decided that only a hidden camera would be able to help him catch the grave's thief red-handed. He looked around and found a suitable camera that would do the job. A camera that's small enough to be hidden in the bushes and blend in with the environment seamlessly. He also made sure that it had night vision and that it emits no light or sound while recording to not alert the culprits. Jacob set the camera inside the bushes a few feet away from his son's grave and turned it on, hoping that it would give him the answers he's looking for. Thankfully, the camera did just that, as when Jacob retrieved it and checked the recording, he discovered that it wasn't an animal or some mysterious phenomenon, but rather a man who was purposely collecting the items that Jacob left on McCade's grave. The thief was also recorded nonchalantly walking around stealing from other nearby graves as well. The man seemed used to the act as he showed no sign of apprehension or hesitation as he looted whatever he could find, showing no respect to the dead nor the feelings of their beloved ones. The thief was not acting alone, as the camera captured a second figure lurking around as well. Yet the footage was of poor quality, and the video wasn't clear enough to identify the perpetrators, who looked like shady figures. In an effort to get a better resolution video and hopefully identify the thieves, Jacob went back to the graveyard and changed the position of the camera, though he wasn't sure he'd be as lucky the second time around. As old habits are hard to die, the thieves returned a second time to loot the toys that the Armstrongs left for them as bait. And this time, the footage was much clearer, as the face of the old man was clearly apparent in the video. Yet this time he was acting alone without last time's partner. The couple also got in touch with local authorities to access the security camera footage at the cemetery in order to better identify the thieves. They took all the evidence they had to a local news team to assist them in their search and get footage to a wider audience. And after that, Jacob and Tashonda approached the local North Enid Police Department with their story and the camera footage they had. The case was handled by Deputy Chief James Lodgson, who sympathized with the Armstrongs, having his own sister buried a few feet away from Little McCade's grave. The news team broadcasted the footage, and in no time, calls started coming in, providing tips regarding the identity of the man in the videotape. The police used the tips to identify and locate the 77-year-old man, Alfred Boyer, who was arrested at his house and was charged with larceny. The Armstrongs met Boyer, who expressed his regret for his deed and apologized to the parents, saying that he's not a bad person and didn't think his act would have such an effect on them. Yet the investigations didn't stop there, as the Armstrong wanted the second person who appeared in the first footage to be held accountable as well. Boyer told the police that the second person that was with him was a 58-year-old woman named Jo Faye Witt, who was arrested by the deputy chief, James Lodgson, at Brahms Restaurant where she worked. The old woman didn't show any signs of surprise when the police confronted her with the charges for which she was being arrested, as she had prior run-ins with the law. Witt had already served a jail sentence for multiple crimes such as prostitution and food stamp fraud. The second thief gave a full account of what they did and how they did it, claiming that she didn't think that taking such things from the cemetery was considered a theft. Witt claimed that she and Boyer read an article from Memorial Park Cemetery that clearly asked people to remove items from gravesites so that workers could mow the lawn. Yet that story didn't help exempt her from a jail sentence, as no one with good intentions would take other people's belongings, even if the owner is a dead child. The old woman was charged with a misdemeanor count of petty larceny and a misdemeanor count of knowingly concealing stolen property, and was sentenced to 6 months in jail and a $500 fine. Everyone involved, including Jacob and Tashonda, were so happy to see the perpetrators being brought to justice and the cemetery safe again. This story shows how a lack of consideration regarding taking something as trivial as a pinwheel can deeply hurt the feelings of other people. And though the dead can't stand up for themselves, they still deserve our full respect as they peacefully sleep in their final resting place. Did you enjoy today's story? Let us know what you think about it in the comments. If you believe this story was amazing, don't hesitate to share it with your buddies. Hit the subscribe button and activate the notification bell so you'll never miss your daily dose of incredible stories.